Half of the babies born this year will live to be 100. Is this a temporary trend or humankind 2.0? According to legend, Spanish explorer Juan Ponce de León landed in Florida in search of the Fountain of Youth. Today, the closest thing we have is a water hazard on the 17th hole of a golf course in Boca Raton. So we didn't find the Fountain of Youth, but we have managed to drastically extend the human lifespan over the last 100 years or so. So how did we do that? Things like improvements in agriculture or medical breakthroughs, like a doctor saying, maybe I should wash my hands before I perform surgery. Now a special report from the Obvious News Network. One way to increase your lifespan is to avoid getting sick. In Okinawa, people often live to the age of 100, so how do they do that? It's through a combination of things such as a low-calorie diet that's really rich in omega-3s, lots of regular exercise, and good genes. Right now, we can't really modify our genes that much, but we have the technology to analyze our DNA through saliva samples and determine if we're at risk for certain diseases, things like Alzheimer's or diabetes or cancer. But even if you're avoiding sickness or treating anything that you already have, you're still aging. You're still getting wrinkles, you're still shaking your fist at rowdy teenagers, which raises the question, what exactly is aging anyway? Though aging is a complex process, one aspect is that every time your cells divide, little DNA caps on the end of your chromosomes called telomeres get shorter. And once they're gone, the cell dies. Scientists at Harvard recently genetically engineered mice to have a gene with an enzyme that reverses this shortening, and the mice essentially got younger. It hasn't been tried yet on humans, but these short enzyme treatments might awaken sleeping stem cells, which repair tissues from the inside. All right, so we're gonna live healthier for a longer portion of our lives. That's great, but what if we wanna actually make our lifespans longer? One bet might be regenerative medicine. Surgeons in Sweden recently gave a man a trachea transplant. They scanned his trachea, and then they built a new one using stem cells taken from his bone marrow. That meant there was no donor and almost no risk of his body rejecting the trachea. Another option would be to print organs using a 3D bioprinter. You know, like we talked about back in episode 3 of this series. As these things move closer and closer to reality, some hard questions come up. If people are born but they don't die, where do we put them? And on a more existential level, if there is no aging, what does death mean? We haven't found the Fountain of Youth, but maybe one day we will. Then you have to ask yourself, am I gonna jump in? Well, my response is, last one in's a grumpy old man.